हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक. टुडे आई एम हियर विद द फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर टाइड्स एंड ओशन करेंट्स. होप यू हैव सीन द लास्ट पार्ट्स वेर एवर आई हैव एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दिस टाइड्स एंड ओशन करेंट्स एंड ऑल्सो इन द लास्ट पार्ट आई हैव एक्सप्लेन हाउ द ओशन करेंट्स फॉर्म. सो हियर दैट इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट सम ओशन करेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू नो अबाउट दैट फ्रॉम वेयर दे ओरिजिन एंड वेयर दे आर also meeting and actually what happening due to the meeting with the other also ocean currents. So stay with me to see the full video, and students don't forget to share your valuable feedback, which also it means necessary or which actually motivates me a lot. Okay, so here students, first main two points I will discuss here, some important ocean currents and next is effects of the ocean currents. This point is most important. Obviously all the points are important, but why? Because from this part definitely one or two ocean currents used to come in the exam. Okay, so here I'm going to tell about that some ocean currents. I already have said in the last part that all the oceans are having some ocean currents. They can be warm oceanic current, they can be that either warm or cold. Okay, so all the ocean currents we are not going to learn here in our syllabus. In our syllabus only basically that two oceans, Atlantic Oceans and Pacific Ocean, that Atlantic Ocean three currents we will also learn and Pacific Ocean two currents. Atlantic Ocean, Gulf Stream, Labrador and North Atlantic Drift or the Canary Current, and in that Pacific Ocean Kuroshio and Oeshio or Kuril. Okay, so stay with me to see. Here students, see the map of the world where the ocean currents are showing by arrows, and the red arrows, it is showing the warm ocean currents, and here the blue color arrows showing the cold ocean currents. Okay, so this map will give you overall that idea about the movement of the ocean currents. Now I will discuss here. See students, this blue circle in this map is showing the Gulf of Mexico, from where the Gulf Stream it is coming out and it is moving towards northern direction. Under the impact of westerlies, this warm water current Gulf Stream, it reaches the western coast of Europe up to 70 degree north, and the convergence of this warm current with Labrador, you can see in the map, it is showing Labrador current at the top, and near the Newfoundland result heavy fog. Students, you can see Gulf Stream one, that direction it is showing towards north. Here after reaching 30 degree west and 40 degree north, it splits into two, with the northern stream crossing to northern Europe and the southern stream it recirculating off West Africa. Okay, so this that Gulf Stream, it is also that influencing at the west part of Africa and west part of Europe, not only in the northern part. Is it clear in the map? Now students, in this map, see the Labrador current, which is a cold current of Atlantic Ocean, its origin in the Arctic Ocean, which flows from north to south between Greenland. You are getting to see the top Greenland and between Baffin Islands, that is Davis Strait. Okay, passing southward. Here this Labrador current, basically it average speed is having 28 kilometer per day, and it is bringing iceberg within this water from the Arctic Ocean. And the most important thing, that when Labrador current is meeting to Gulf Stream near Newfoundland, it is forming that dense fog, and the climatic condition which is creating, that is good for growing of the plankton, which is the feed for the fish. That's why the largest fishing ground of the world, Grand Banks, it also formed there. Okay, now we will get to know about the North Atlantic Drift, which is actually another very important that ocean current, which actually that deflects towards that eastern side by the influence of westerly. Actually we can say the Gulf Stream, when by the influence of westerly it is deflecting towards that Europe side.
that is known as North Atlantic Drift, and it is an that warm oceanic current. In this map, you are getting to see the North Atlantic Drift, that is in black color. All the warm currents it is showing in black color. And here, the most important thing that this North Atlantic Drift, it flows in the three direction, eastward to UK, northwards to Arctic region, and southwards along the Spanish coast as the cool Canary's current. You are getting to see in the map clearly it is showing, okay, their directions. Now students, we are going to know about the most two important Pacific Ocean current, Kuroshio current and Kuril current, that is known as Vaishyo current also. So see in the map which is showing the part, that is the part of Pacific Ocean, that one side it is showing Asia and Australia, the west side, and the eastern side showing North America, South America. So here the brown color showing warm currents and dotted line cool currents. Next we will get to know about Kuroshio current, which is the strong western boundary current in the western North Pacific Ocean. It begins off the east coast of Taiwan. You are getting to see in the in that part that islands are there, the, from Taiwan. It is also basically coming and flows northeastward past to Japan, where it merges with the easterly drift of the north. This Kuroshio current actually develops partly due to that Coriolis force and partly due to obstruction of the Philippines in the flow of north equatorial current, and it is having average temperature of 18 degrees centigrade. It moves at the rate of 30 km per day. Actually, this warm current, it helps to keep the eastern coast of Japan warm even in the month of January, when there is we can say that frequent snowfall in the Honshu and Hokkaido in Japan. Okay, it becomes snow free in that month of January even by that influence of Kuroshio current. Now students, an offshoot of that Kuroshio current, which is known as Tsushima current, it enters the sea of Japan, the western part of Japan. It also that become warm by the influence of this current. Okay, now students, we are going to know the last that important cold Pacific Ocean current, that is Kuril or Vaishyo current, actually which originates from that Arctic Ocean and it brings ice back with that. Okay, and this southward movement of this current along the coast of Kamchatka, and it touches the island of Kuril. That's why its name also Kuril current. Kuril is the place of that Russia. One thing here students, not only Kuril part of Russia, here Hokkaido also it get influenced by this Kuril or Vaishyo current. Sometime this kind of question can come, which is the cold current of Pacific Ocean or warm current, you have to answer properly. Now that on Kuroshio current only sustain the coral reefs of Japan, the northernmost coral reefs in the world, that is most important.
Students, you have understood that how these all oceanic currents, they flow from where to which direction, and due to that what actually happened between this also Gulf Stream, Labrador, any one current used to come in the exam. Even in the in between Kuril and Kuroshio, one current can come in your exam. So see that part once again, and their direction always try to remember by that help of map. When you will see the map, you can imagine that. Okay, now here what I am going to tell, that this important that whatever that current I have said, except this, there are so many other currents we can see in the Atlantic Ocean, like Canary, like that also Falkland current, like Benguela current. These are the cold current. And except that, in that Pacific Ocean, like Peru current, like some equatorial current, even California current, these are the different currents we can see in Pacific Ocean. And in the Indian Ocean, we can see Mozambique current, even northeast monsoon current, that southwest monsoon current. These are the different currents we can see, but these are not in our syllabus, so we will not go for any kind of explanation for that. Okay, so whatever they are in our syllabus, we will go for that. Now the next point is the effects of the oceanic currents. Here some effects I have written. See how they are basically due to that oceanic currents, what are the changes are happening and what kind of effects we are getting to see. It mitigates the air temperature. Obviously, whenever any of the oceanic currents passing through our nearby any of the land areas, the temperature obviously it will increase. If their temperature is having less, it will increase. Or if the cold current is passing, the temperature will decrease. So temperature can change with that. So next is fishing ground. Just I have given the example how the fishing ground is forming. When the cold current and the warm current is meeting, due to that temperature change, that fog, dense fog also formation is happening there, as well as this temperature is particular, it means perfect for growing of the plankton, which is the feed of the fishes. They are like that Gulf Stream and Labrador, it is meeting near Newfoundland, and their Grand Banks, the largest fishing ground of the world, it formed there. Next, Titanic. Hope all of you have seen the movie Titanic, even you have heard the story about the Titanic ship, the largest one of that time, the largest one, the ship. When the 2000 passenger actually moving with that ship, in that ship they were present, and the water, it was that cold Atlantic Ocean current, and in that water so many iceberg was there, but people were not known about that, they were, had not seen, because due to that dense, that fog was there, and that's why 1500 people, they had not taken 2 to 3 hours even to sink in the water, even the whole ship sink in the water. Okay, just imagine how what kind of that, it means devastating it can be. So the Titanic accident, it also helped due to that. Number 4, warm ocean currents can melt the ice. Obviously, the warm ocean currents like Kuroshio at the eastern coast of Japan, that it when in the month of January there is no fall, due to that Kuroshio current, the Hokkaido part and Honshu part, it also become free from that kind of snowfall. Why? Because the Kuroshio current is there, the warm oceanic currents, and sometime the cold current which is passing near to that any of the it means area land masses which is having high temperature, it can moderate the temperature, it can suitable, like the area of UK's and near about London, and this area are part of Europe. Okay, next, number 5, it can bring rain whenever that we can see. It can bring rain. So where we can see near to that European part, and here some part Australia, some part of that Queensland, it means part of Australia only, where this the what warm oceanic currents over that, when the wind is blowing, it is holding the moisture, because that when temperature will increase, it is having more capacity to hold the moisture. Obviously, when the moisture will be in the air, the rainfall will be there. And in the case of Atacama and Kalahari, the desert, you know that it is near to that oceanic area, but they are desert. Why? Because the cold oceanic current passing nearby that. That's why when the cold oceanic current, it is having less temperature, and no, it is very dry. That's why no absorption of that moisture, no rainfall there. Okay, sometimes it questions, sometimes it comes to the mind of the students, the Atacama and Kalahari, the desert, it is situated at that oceanic part, the coastal area, but why it is desert? This is that because it is nearby that the cold current, so many reasons are there, but it is also one of the most important reason, that cold current passing, that's why it is having that dry, that wind, and which is having less moisture, and due to that no rainfall is there. Next, bad weather conditions near to that Newfoundland. When that meeting of that warm current and cold current, and they are meeting and converging, due to that dense, that also fog formation happening there. And this dense that fog actually not suitable for navigation. Even sometime that cold current is coming from the polar area, they are bringing some icebergs, which is not good. You know that icebergs only one part we can get to see above the water floating, but nine part it is below the water, which means under that water we can't get to see. That's why the Titanic also ship, it basically that strikes and they sink. Here the same thing. So this kind of bad weather condition we can get to see in that near Newfoundland due to the convergence of that hot, cold and warm current, and near about 9 months. So many other results can be there. You can write. So here, students. So these effects you just learn. You can may in the exam can ask one or two points. You can write that. If you have understood, you can write by your own. And then that whatever parts I have also explained in that map, see that once again. So students, see that whole five parts, actually two parts before that tides I have explained, then I have explained in that map one part, then two parts I have taken for that ocean currents. See all the parts and then whatever also you have understood, you can make your own notes. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.